Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn about load balancer. Why do we need load balancer? Basically, it distributes the incoming traffic across the target. Load balancer automatically distributes incoming application traffic across multiple target. It enables us to achieve the greater level of fault tolerance in our application, providing the required amount of load balancing capacity needed to distribute the application traffic. Here is the diagram how the load balancer will work. Different type of load balancer. There are three type of load balancer. One is application load balancer and a network load balancer and classic load balancer. How it varies? It depends on the workload, what we have the requirement in our environment. Application load balancer provide an advanced routing and visibility feature targeted at application architecture. It includes microservices and container. It uses the protocol HTTP and HTTPS. So the next one is network load balancer. Use the protocol TCP, TLS and UDP. Network load balancer are capable of handling millions of requests per second securely while maintaining ultra low latencies. The last one is classic load balancer. Classic load balancer use the existing application that is having EC2 classic network. It also use the HTTPS and TCP. So basically it use the existing classic network. Before going to the load balancer, we need to pass the parameter while configuring it. So there are certain parameter we need to give. Of course, you need to give the name and the scheme. Scheme is important. There are two types of scheme. One is internet facing, another one is internal. An internet facing load balancer has publicly resolved DNS name. So it can route requests from client over the internet to the EC2 instance that are registered with the load balancer. Internal, the node of an internal load balancer have only private IP address. So you can choose in the wide area network internal. Of course, VPC is very important. You need to choose the right VPC where you want to connect. Listener is very important. You must add one or more listener. We'll discuss about that. Availability zone. Availability zone is very important. So load balancer route the request to the registered target in the availability zone. Load balancer is most effective if we ensure that each enabled availability zone has at least one registered target. So you need to select the availability zone. You can see in the screen there are three subnets. So either you can choose, you know, different region subnet. To enable the availability zone, select checkbox for the availability zone if there is more than one subnet for the availability zone. Select one of the subnet. If you can select only one subnet per availability zone. Configuring the security group. So security group, basically it's important when you create the EC2 is it allows the inbound and outbound traffic. When you add the port number, let's say you have the RDP 3389 and SSH, you can use 22. So basically you need to add this security group when you add the load balancer. Either you can choose existing or the new security group as well. Routing. So we need to configure the routing. You can create the target group or you can also use the existing target group. Target name is important. So you have different type of target type. So instance, IP, lambda function. Target, you need to specify the specific instance ID when you choose instance. IP address, of course, you need to enter the IP address. And the third one is lambda function. You can register your Lambda function as target and configure a listener rule to forward requests to the target group. For your Lambda function, when you load balancer forward the request to the target group with the Lambda function as a target, it invokes your Lambda function to pass content. So we need to give the protocol port number. Health check. Health check is important. It gives a machine health check, how it is, whether it is healthy or unhealthy, and also you can select the threshold. There are different parameters, you can choose it. Of course, either you can choose a protocol HTTP or HTTPS, whatever the protocol you want, you can choose it. And the protocol load balancer uses when routing traffic to the target in this target group. And the destination path health check, the path must be with the slash character because you can add the default file. The port number, load balancer used when performing health check on target. The default is port where on which the each target receives the traffic from the load balancer. And the threshold, next one is unhealthy threshold. So you can configure the threshold, it checks the connectivity health check, whether it's success or not. It considering unhealthy target, so 2 to 10, and you have the the intervals, the amount of time in seconds, so during which no response from the health check, and it returns that saying that unhealthy state. So the approximate amount of time between health check of an individual target is 5 to 300 second. So register a target, that is the last one. Once you have passed all the parameter during the configuration, it should be successfully registered. And you can see the instant name and then listener ID and port number, everything you can see. So when you register easy to instant as a target, you must ensure that security group for your instant allow the load balancer to communicate with your instances and both listener and port and the health check port. Thanks everyone. You can share your feedback to the mail ID we learn forever at gmail.com. Thank you.